Okay, when we talk about the South Hebron Hills area, we are talking about Palestinian villages that are spreaded in the South Hebron Hills area, and this area is extended down and down until the Green Line. All the Palestinians, they are living in small villages like the village of Sarura. Mostly they live in caves and tents, without any services, without, you know, water running, electricity, roads, health services. And since the Israeli occupation of the 67 until this moment, the Israeli occupation authority working hard just to make the life of the Palestinians harder and harder to push them to leave. First, they divided this area for two different parts. One part is declared as a firing zone area and they named it 19th, and the other part is targeted by confiscating the Palestinian land and establishing the settlements. Almost every week we have like demolition somewhere like in the area. The sheep, they are grazing their sheep and they might like enter a closed military area or in a place, and this is like an excuse for them to being arrested.
يتخيلوا بشنات 2000 بلوتا كل אנשים مخربة خروبة مخربة سرورة من المفقرة من كل يزور شلا مسافر يطا أريم شل دروم شل خفرون עשו פינוי לשש חודשים, שאמרו זה שטח צבאי. ב-2000 היית בגיל 35, אבל 35 שנה אני לא ראיתי אף פעם הצבא לא מתאמנת בתוך שטח פלסטיניים. התחיל לעשות חוות מעון, התחילו לבנות אביגי, לבנות מספר העיר, עשו איזה 10 מתנחלות. איך אתה אמרת, זה שטח אש ואתה מתחיל לשים יהודים חדשים או מתנחלות חדשות?
The goal of all these agricultural settlements, everything was like completely clear that pushing us forcefully to respond in a violent way. Why? They need like kind of excuses there to be easy for them to implement their strategy or policy of eviction. Since that time, you know, we started like in this way, the non-violent joint struggle. I mean, having Israelis, internationals, Palestinians all together, you know, and fighting the occupation. You can imagine, like, without any services, you know, aggressive rule, settlers violence, you know, so no stability at all. But, you know, the Palestinians, they are creating life among all these injustices. Now we reach, like, the point of Sumud. The idea of Sumud is how to encourage those people who already left to come back to their, you know, caves, to their land, and to restart again their life. The plan is first to show to everyone the effectiveness of the non-violent joint struggle, okay? And to tell everyone, our struggle with the occupation, it's not like religious struggle. We are all Muslims, Christians, Jew, we are all together, you know, we are fighting for the injustice, okay, and we are fighting just to put an end for the occupation. So we decided like to do it, I mean to come down to the village and to start like rehabilitating the caves and, you know, to plant the trees and so on. Now we are using like this place until we encourage the people to come back, and then the plan is how to rehabilitate most of the caves here and to help the people and to get them to come back, and to coordinate also and to work with the owners of the land. We see like the willing for them to come back, but you know, they had really a very bad experience, and you know, really, we can't like blame them. They care for like their kids, their families, and so on. They were like three times like the Israeli army raid the camp and, you know, destroy things, you know, even used like a violence against the volunteers here and destroying and, you know, confiscating the things of the camp, even like the mattresses and the generator, all the things like for doing living here, you know, they confiscated. Last week, you know, they arrested like one of the activists and you know they put him in jail like for 3 days. There was not like clear charge for him, so they released him until after we pay like the fine for him. And also they arrested another child, my son also, he's 13. They can use any military excuses, you know, just to arrest, you know, and to do all these things, you know. They can like enter like the caves, destroy it, do whatever, you know. But you know, we never give up, and we are continuing here in Sumud.